Good morning, students. This is our last session, linguistics. Good morning to all of you. So I'm going to share the screen because I want to present a reflection. Okay. So it's important to... I'm going to call the roll and you're going to say present or here. Okay, Rafael. Rafael. Say hello.
I'm here.
Okay, Brittany.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Yeah, Brittany. Edith.
Present, teacher.
Elianis.
Teacher. Present, teacher.
Rosalyn.
Present, teacher.
Alain.
Present, teacher.
Odalis.
Present, teacher.
Alan.
I am here, teacher.
Okay. And Mariluz. Mariluz. Okay. So this is our last session. And today we're going to share some topics about linguistics and the interference of the second language and the first language. We face some troubles. The differences between our first and our second language and how it is possible to improve or to know the differences between both languages. But first, I want to share with you this video that is about motivation. Okay, What do you think about this comment? Comments about this? What do you think?
Oh, yeah. Bueno, empecé a verlo un poquito tarde, pero él ahí estaba hablando de las características del león, porque es el rey de la selva, porque domina tanto, porque está. Entonces comienza a describir de su sagacidad, su temperamento, su dominio, cómo él dominaba. Y entonces me pareció interesante algo que decía, que no necesitamos ser súper inteligentes, no necesitamos ser el boom de la hora, simplemente necesitamos ser nosotros mismos y sacar lo que decía, saca el león que tienes dentro. Y ese león representa estabilidad, representa serenidad, representa autenticidad. Y bueno, como ejemplo, en el curso en el que estamos, en el curso de inglés, compartía con mis compañeros del grupo, que a veces nos metemos en este curso pensando en que todos van a hablar en inglés, todos van a hablar perfectamente y bueno, con el temor a equivocarme no participo, no digo nada. Y no es lo correcto, no es lo correcto porque les decía que es necesario que nuestros errores salgan a la luz para que puedan ser corregidos. Es necesario que podamos ser educados, que podamos ser corregidos. Y entonces tendremos esa estabilidad, tendremos esa confianza. Hablaba de que el león tiene confianza en sí mismo. Entonces, eso nos abre las puertas. Es mi aporte en este momento.
Okay. Muchas gracias, Rafael. Sí, me llama la atención que aunque el león no es el más rápido, no es el más grande, pero Maybelline. Okay. Ok, no es el más grande, no es el más rápido, de repente no es el más ágil, pero se considera el rey. ¿Por qué? Porque él ve todo a su alrededor como posible alimento, sin ver, sin poner atención que ese otro animal pueda ser más grande, que pueda ser más rápido, porque su confianza, su optimismo, la motivación que él tiene es la que lo lleva a ser, como quien dice, el rey. Él confía en su capacidad. Y con respecto a lo que usted dice aquí, ¿verdad?, su compañero, ese es el goal, el target point. Usted espera o supone aprender a hablar inglés. But you should say risk taker. Usted debe tomar riesgo, así como dijo su compañero, hablar, así usted lo diga mal, así usó la gramática incorrecta, así lo pronuncie mal, no importa. ¿Por qué? Porque usted está en un proceso que se llama language acquisition o language learning. Si usted está con una persona en su entorno que habla inglés, y usted practique, eso se llama language acquisition, porque usted lo va a aprender de una manera natural. Si lo hacemos en un setting como este, es language learning, porque estamos tratando de aprender reglas, sintax, gramática, todas esas cosas, ¿verdad? Pero usted tiene que practicar. No lo va a hacer bien, ni la primera ni la segunda. Esto es un proceso en el cual usted, con la práctica, usted va a aprender. Cometiendo errores, cuando un bebé tiene meses, ese bebé no habla, solamente balbucea y emite sonidos, pero él está escuchando, y cuando ese bebé empieza a hablar, él no habla correctamente, él habla con errores, de repente con ciertos problemas, ciertos errores gramaticales, pero él lo hace. Y con el transcurrir del tiempo, él de forma natural aprende a hablar correctamente. So the same occurs with us. At the beginning, we are going to commit mistakes, but we are in the process of learning. Y vamos aprendiendo poco a poco, así que atrévase. Deje el miedo, atrévase, porque esto es cuestión de práctica. No hay otra manera. Entonces, otra cosita que yo les voy a decir, miren, ya por ser la última clase. Usted tiene herramientas. Le voy a decir qué tipo de herramientas. Usted va a ver una película. Véala en inglés. No, pero que yo no entiendo nada. No importa que usted no entienda nada. No importa. Porque su cerebro está internalizando esas palabras y esos sonidos. Así como lo hace el bebé, que no habla, pero está escuchando lo que papá y mamá le dicen. No importa que usted no entienda nada. Cuando tenemos esa televisión por cable, ellos tienen una opción donde aparecen los subtítulos. Usted puede ver esa película y le ponen los subtítulos en inglés y el audio en inglés. Y créame que usted con el tiempo, usted va a ir aprendiendo. Porque usted va viendo la pronunciación, usted va viendo las palabras y usted va viendo lo que la persona está diciendo y usted va viendo allí. ¿Qué dice? Esos subtítulos. No lo ponga en español. Porque usted habla español, póngalo en inglés. ¿Ah? Usted va a oír canciones, póngalas en inglés. En YouTube tenemos videos de canciones, tenemos videos documentales, lo que sea. Y en la partecita hacia abajo, en YouTube, hay un cuadrito que usted toca y dice subtítulos. Póngale los subtítulos en inglés. Usted no va a aprender inglés escuchando canciones en español, escuchando a Sammy Sandra, escuchando a Bad, ¿cómo es? Bad Bunny y eso. Usted va a aprender escuchando en inglés. Dígame, Edith.
No, profe, que le iba a decir que eso que usted dice, profe, es muy cierto. Porque yo tuve compañeras allá en Boca y ella me hablaba en inglés. Bueno, entonces ahora, cuando yo termino la clase, yo siempre le hablo lo poco que he aprendido aquí, yo le hablo a ella, y ella se estaba riendo y dice, bien, teacher, pero digo, bien, pero si usted sabe que yo no estoy pronunciando y que de repente no llevo las reglas, porque yo sigo traduciendo el español a sí mismo, palabra por palabra. Entonces no lo hago, por ejemplo, con las reglas gramaticales y todo, dice ella, pero eso está muy bien. Y ella me sugirió justamente eso, que escuchara música en inglés, porque a mí me gusta escuchar música. Entonces me dice, teacher, escucha música. Ella me dice, teacher, a mí. Me dice que escucha música en inglés, siempre está viendo cosas en inglés, palabras que tú veas en la calle en inglés, y trata de que cuando lo que tú veas, o sea, el diario vivir, por ejemplo, en vez de hablar allá en la casa y que quiero una taza de café, mentalmente pídete a ti una taza de café en inglés para que tú veas que vas a lograr mucho. Bueno, considero que en estos días pues he logrado algo y eso para mí es relevante. Como dice aquí el compañero, la intención de todos es que podamos hablar al final del técnico, pero también queda de nuestra parte. Porque todo el docente no lo puede ofrecer. Nosotros tenemos que buscar otras herramientas que nos permitan, ¿verdad? Ampliar esos conocimientos, ampliar esa práctica y, pues, no llegar a la perfección, pero de repente podernos comunicar, pues, así como a veces yo me siento cohibida, ¿sí? Cuando yo veo que, por ejemplo, muchos de los compañeros hablan y ellos hablan fluido con usted, como que estamos hablando aquí en español perfectamente. Entonces, a veces me siento cohibida, pero yo digo, no, si yo estoy aquí, digo, yo estoy por aprender. O sea que esto, para todos no tenemos las mismas capacidades, los mismos potenciales, pero tenemos que tratar al menos, ¿verdad?, de que los objetivos que nos hemos trazado de manera personal, pues los lleguemos a cumplir.
Exacto. Thank you. Okay, we are going to continue because time is is running and goes. Okay, a review about the concept we have learned during this subject. Okay, we have learned few things, but things that are very important. So what is language? In your own words, language. Tell us, a volunteer, what is language? Expressed in your own words, tell us.
It's a tool. It's a tool that we can use for feelings, emotions, to try to, how do you say that? When you want to somebody understand what are you thinking, understand what you want. And so that's why we use not only words, not only spoken, not only speak, we can use mimics, we can use, how do you say this, did you?
What do you say?
How do you say stickle? When you do things with your face?
Gestures, facial expressions.
Yes, the expression with my face. I can shout doing in love to express happiness. I am happy. I can shouting, but my face show like I am happy. But I can shout and show you angry. And so that is a tool what we can use in language, not only speaker, maybe to expression phrases, and expression mimics to that thing.
Okay, thank you. You explained everything. Language may be oral, may be written, involve facial expression, gesture, movement, total physical movement, nonverbal communication. And it is important to say that we may transmit emotion, feeling, thoughts, knowledge, commands, all the things we are going to transmit to others. It's a tool. It's something that is important for human beings. It's the way we use to communicate. Okay. What is linguistics? Linguistics is a science that studies all the elements of the language. It doesn't matter the language. Linguistics studies all the elements of the languages. So linguistics has some branches. Do you remember these branches? There are six branches. Do you remember this? Branches?
Oh my.
One is phonetics.
Phonetics?
Uh-huh.
Syntax.
Syntax.
Semantics.
Semantics.
Phonology.
Phonology.
Something else.
Pragmatics,
and the last one. It begins with M. It studies the words, the root of the word. Do you remember the root of the word?
Morphology.
Very good. Morphology. Okay. So as a manner of review, six branches or six elements. Okay. We have the phonetics. Phonetics is the representation of the sound, and it tells us how and where the sound is produced. Then we have phonology. Phonology studies the rules that governs the sound and how do we use this, and how the pronunciation or the use of this may interfere or change the meaning of the words. That's phonology. Then we have semantics and pragmatics. Semantics study the representation that we have of this word in our mind. And pragmatic is the use in context of this word. So then we have morphology. Morphology is the part of linguistics that study the word, the structure of the word. And we have syntax that study the order of the sentences and the elements of the speech. Okay, as we said, morphology study the parts of the word or the roots of the word. So we study two concepts. We study free morpheme and bound morpheme. Do you remember what is free morpheme? You may review what is free morpheme and bound morpheme. I'm going to tell you, and you're going to tell me what is the answer. When the word may stand alone, alone, is free or is bound morpheme?
I think it's free.
Is free.
Because you say is when the word is alone.
When the word may stand alone. Example, if I said talk, is a free morpheme. But if I said talking, the free morpheme is talk, and the bound morpheme is ing. If I said talker, the free morpheme is talk, and the bound morpheme er. Okay? Let's continue with the review. Okay, sorry. Okay. We talk about the elements of speech. Elements of speech. So we have the elements of speech are adverbs, adjective, verbs, nouns, articles, preposition, pronouns, conjunctions. Okay, so let's talk one by one. What is a verb? Do you remember what is a verb?
Action.
It's a word that denotes action. Is the action, okay. I'm going to tell you, and you're going to tell me what is the word that describes a noun. It's a word that describes a noun. What is?
Could describe a noun.
Describes a noun. What is?
Is the adjective.
It's an adjective. The adjective describes the noun. Okay. What is the word that describes or modifies the verb? Describes or modifies the verb.
Modifies
the verb.
Oh, I don't remind.
We are need to do.
It's the word that modifies the verb. For example, if I said Fulanito runs quickly. Modifies the verb. Quickly. What is quickly?
Is a is adverb.
Is an adverb. Very good. Is an adverb. The word that modifies the verb is an adverb. The word that modifies a noun is an adjective. Okay, so we have the following word. The following word is a noun. What is a noun? What is a noun?
Is a person and
person?
Animals and
animal, person, animal.
Things, creo que es cosa, things.
Things, very good. A person, animal, thing, maybe places, countries that usually may be the subject in a sentence. Okay? People, animal, thing, places. People, animal, things, places are nouns. Okay, very good. So what is a pronoun? Pronoun, pronoun. Do you remember what is a pronoun?
The pronoun is she, it.
Okay, good. These are pronouns. So it is possible to say that pronoun is the word that substitutes the noun in a sentence. For example, if I said Maria is my teacher, so it is possible to substitute Maria using the pronoun she. She is my teacher. Okay. Mm-hmm. Pronoun is the word that may substitute the noun. Okay. So now we have prepositions, articles, and conjunction. Okay. What is a conjunction? Conjunction is a word that may join sentences or phrases. For example, we have but, and, nor. These are conjunctions, words that may join sentences. I need to go to the school, but is a conjunction. I don't have a car. Okay, that is a conjunction. Another example may be, so I want to buy a car, but I don't have money. That is a conjunction. It joins two sentences. Okay, what is a preposition? It's a word that usually tells us about time or places. Okay, for example, in, on, in front, over are prepositions. Around, okay, tell us or indicates places, indicates time. And also we have the article. The articles, for example, we have the undetermined articles. So we have the, as we say in Spanish, el, la, los, las. So in English, we use the, okay, article. So these are the elements of speech. Okay, finally, I want to review some concepts. Number one says, what is the meaning of the word prefix? The meaning of the word prefix. A word within a word. A group of letters put before a root word which changes its meaning. A group of letters put at the end of a root word changes its meaning. Prefix. Prefix. A word within a word. A group of letters put before a root word which changes its meaning. A group of letters put at the end of a root we change the meaning. What is the answer?
Before, teacher.
Before a root.
Before a root. Exactly. Very good. It's a group of letters before. Unrealistic. Unrealistic. Okay. If you take away, if you take away the prefix from disagree, the root word is agree, true or false?
Yeah, it says suffix.
Pay attention to the statement. It says, if you take away, take away the prefix, the prefix, the root word is agree, true or false?
I don't understand.
Okay, let's divide the word. Let's divide the word. This agree. What is the prefix in this case?
Yes.
This is the prefix. Okay. This is the prefix. If I take away, disagree, yes or no? True or false?
Claro, profe. Cierto.
Is true. If we take away the prefix, the root word is agree. That's true. Okay. What do you do if you reread a book? Reread a book. Okay. Don't read it. Read it again. Read it for the first time. What do you do if you reread a book? Don't read it. Read it again. Read it for the first time.
Read again.
Read it again. Reread. Read it again. Good. Thank you, students, for your participation. Now we are going to listen to the speeches. Okay. So we have Rafael and Alan. Let's listen to your classmates.
All right. Alan is first, so he will make the presentation first. So I have ready my presentation here too. If Alan is there.
Okay. Can you see my screen?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Hello class, good morning teacher and classmen. Today Rafaela and me good talk about the different in B and B sounds. Give me a second. Okay, how we can see in the following photo, the mount must be in a specific position for the sound of the B. I can say three examples. Beat, be, baby. You need have your mouse in one specific position for the air outside, not outside of the mouse. You can see the difference between the Spanish. Example, bomba, libro, bandera. I don't know what happened. I can't cross this guy.
Yeah, that's in mine. All right, teacher, it's my time. Well, as you can see, we select three words in English and three words Spanish to appreciate the pronunciation of the letter V. V. All right. As you see the picture, the first picture, we have radiology image. You see that the lips are to back over our teeth, our up teeth. So that will make the sound not B, will sound V. V. That sound produced when you put out back the lips inside the mouth, and that make not V. That make not the sound B, it make the sound V. As you say, the second picture, the mouth is all closed, not all closed, is between the teeth and the lips, and the air flow into the inside of mouth. The air flows and make this sound. V. It sounds a live. This sound a live. Over. Over. That sound over with my lips in the back of the over cheeks. Violet. Violet. But in Spanish we say vivir. It is same sound, it's similar to sound. Viento, viento, violeta, violeta. That is sound produced when you use the articulation correctly. When you can practice the modulation of a voice, the position of the lips, because we need to use all our mouth, our sound phonator machine. I don't know how to say it. So that's what you can use. Put the next picture, please, Alan. The next page. There I put something very important. B have not a teeth. B is only lips. It's and not some beep like you think. It's some that sound like a baby say like a baby do that. So when we pronounce some word with B like bottom, like basic, we use this moving in our lips. B, B. But when we use the letter V, we need to use our teeth, our up teeth, in on the lips and the down lips to the back, from the back of the teeth. V, V, like violet, like version, like visions, right? So thanks for watching us. This is our team. And thank you, teacher, for this time. Right. Thank you, Alan.
Okay, thank you, students. So I want to contribute with some information. There is a phenomenon that occurs. This phenomenon is studied by phonology. Okay, as I said, the second class phonetic study, the graphic representation of the sound. As your classmate says, we have two different sounds, the sound of v, v, and the sound of b, b. B is a bilabial sound, as he explained in a very good way. B. What is the difference? We use both lips, lower and upper lip. B. B. Book. And what occurs with v, v is a labiodental sound. Labiodental. Lips and teeth. Labiodental. Lower lip, upper teeth. V. It occurs in English. But what happens in Spanish? In Spanish, we have an allophoneme. What is allophoneme? Is a sound that we use to pronounce both sounds. So instead of said viene, we said viene fulano. Instead of say vaca, we don't say vaca, we said vaca. Viene, bueno, bonito, barato, vena. We use the allophoneme to pronounce these sounds. Okay. So there is a way to avoid this, and it's practicing minimal prayers. Why? It is because in Spanish, it doesn't cause troubles. Okay? It doesn't cause conflict in meaning. Okay. What happened if in Spanish we say vaca or vaca? Cambia el sentido, cambia lo que decimos, y we said vaca o vaca. Vena, vena. Change the meaning? It changes the meaning? ¿Cree usted que cambia el significado? ¿Interfiere?
No, in the...
¿Verdad que no? No.
No, but it's because we are from Latin America, but maybe in Spain, it's so strange talk this form, because maybe these people go say it's different. Maybe thing is, oh, maybe significate other thing. Because the people in Latin America don't have difference for the B or B.
Okay, and that is something that is important, because we say, oh, in Spanish, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter because it doesn't affect meaning. It's like in English, when we say water or water, it doesn't affect the meaning. It doesn't affect meaning. But what happened with sounds that change the meaning? Oh, that's important, because if we pronounce wrong, it is going to change the meaning. Okay, if we have, for example, berry, berry, we are talking about a fruit, berry and very. So it is important to practice in this case, minimal pairs. Why? Because the pronunciation is going to affect meaning. It's not the same if I said berry or very. Boat, vote. Bat, vat. Van, van. Big, big. So it is going to affect meaning. So for this reason, it is important to know when the allophoneme may affect meaning or not. So in Spanish, it doesn't affect meaning. No afecta para nada en español que usted diga zapato zapato. Que usted diga vaca o diga vaca. Que usted diga vena o diga vena. It doesn't affect. It doesn't affect meaning. But in English, it affects. En inglés afecta. En este caso, in this case, we are not going to use the allophoning. No vamos a usar el allophoning, sino los fonemas correctos. Because it's not the same to say very or very. Boat, vote. Bat, vat. Van, van. And how can we avoid this? ¿Cómo podemos solucionar esto? ¿Cómo podemos enfrentarlo? ¿Cómo podemos eliminar este problema? Practicing minimal curse. Practicing pronunciation. When we have the sound of b, we're going to practice b, b, b. It sounds strange for us, but you may do this using a mirror. B, b, v, 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 b, b, b. And you're going to practice very, very. Vote, vote. And you may avoid this problem by practicing this. Suena así como un poquito así, uno a veces se siente como medio tontito así haciendo eso, but, but it's necessary. It happens with other sounds, for example, the sound of vowels as in E or E when you say ship or sheep, okay? Team, team, but it's necessary. Okay, thank you for your presentation. Excellent. I want to listen to the other group. Remember, it is important practice minimal pairs. Minimal pairs. So now I'm going to listen to Edith and her group.
Good morning, teacher and classmate. We are group number one. Mm-hmm. Now, to talk about the adverbs.
Mm-hmm. Déjame desactivar la cámara, por favor.
The adverb is the invariable word that express circumstances of place, time, meanings, and quality, or affirmation, a negation, and download. Yeah. Adverbs play. This, her, up, down, inside, outside. Adverb of time is today. Now, yesterday, later, many adverbs make up a feminine adjective, the ending mente. Example, quality, in Spanish is amorosamente, cuidadosamente. In English is carefully, lovely. También adverb, the quantity is much, many, much, many, less, adverb, the affirmation is yes, no, yes, no, perhaps the difference adverb in Spanish and English. Es que the adverb and in are placed after the verb. In Spanish, they can at the beginning of sentence. The article, the difference and the article on the Spanish and English is indefinite y indefinite. El indefinite is in Spanish, I have four feminine, masculine, singular and plural. Example, uno, una, 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 uno, una, unos, unas. In English, have two, or an. Example, I need a favor. And I bought an apple in Spanish, una vaca, unas sillas, un libro, unos documentos. Ya, teacher, le corresponde a la otra compañera.
Ok, the next.
Ok, the adjective. An adjective is a word that modifies a noun or pronoun by describing, identifies or qualified word. Example, the tall man. The adjective is tall. In the structure is a sentence is a grammatical structure formed by a subject and a predicate. Each sentences can have one verb in each verb correspond to only on subject. For example, is we buy a car. We need buy a car in Spanish is the subject and the verb are in place. We need it structure in English, then the direct object in English car. Thank you, teacher.
Okay, there are many similarities and some differences that may affect when we are learning English. So one of the things that I consider, could you see my PowerPoint? Could you see the PowerPoint, students? Okay. So one of the things that call my attention is that affect us is the use of s when we are talking in simple present tense. That is an important difference. In Spanish, we said yo trabajo, ella trabaja, él trabaja. What happened in English? We said I work. But what happened when we said she work? What happened? We have to add s to the verb. If we said he, we have to add the s, works. So that is something that is important and is one important difference. Remember, add the S in simple present tense. Another difference is the negation. In Spanish, we said yo, or no, we said no tengo nada. No tengo nada. That is double negation. No is a negation. Nada is a negation. No tengo nada. In English, if we translate this, ¿cuál sería la traducción de esto? In English, literally,
I don't have,
¿cómo se dice nada?
No, nothing.
Okay. ¿Esto qué sería la traducción? Dije, literal, I don't have nothing. Yo no tengo nada, but that's wrong. No es la correcta. Because in English we don't use double negation. En inglés no se usan las dobles negaciones. No se usan. Yo no digo I don't have nothing. Se dicen I don't have anything. Solo una negación. I don't have anything. Algo, okay? Or I can say, I have nothing. What is a negation? Nothing. I have nothing or I don't have anything. No se usa doble negación as we do in Spanish. No tengo nada. Another important difference. I'm going to use the same example. In Spanish, we said, no tengo nada. What is the subject? What is the subject? No tengo nada. What is the subject?
Ese es tácito, profe.
Decimos tácito, ¿verdad? But in English, yo no puedo decir, don't have anything. Yo no puedo decir eso. ¿Qué le falta? What is missing?
Sujeto.
Subject. In English, I have to use the subject. I don't have anything. In Spanish, we said, duermo. How is in English? Duermo. Como. In English, I said, I sleep.
I eat.
So it is only necessary to use the subject. Another important difference is the use of auxiliary. In Spanish, we don't use auxiliaries. We said no, and that's all. But in English, it is necessary to use the auxiliary. The auxiliary. Done or does not. Okay? Or do or does. Do you or does she? What's the meaning? Y usted me pregunta, así como me preguntan los chicos a veces en el colegio, profe, pero ¿qué significa do y qué significa does allí en esa oración? Y yo le digo, no significa nada, pero tiene que ir ahí. So that is grammar. So it is necessary to use this to follow that grammatical structure correctly. Do you need this and this? Do you need this and this? Does she need this and this? So it is important to use the auxiliary. Okay, another important difference is the position of the adjective, the position. In Spanish, we said, el niño bonito, la casa grande, el libro este libro pequeño. That is in Spanish. So what happened in English? We are going to move this. The order change. We said the pretty boy.
Boy.
Change. What change? A position of the adjective changes. Okay, so we say the pretty boy. So instead of la casa grande, instead of say the house big literary, we are going to use
the big house.
It changed the position, not the meaning, changes the position. El libro pequeño. So we're going to change the same. The structure, the small book. Okay. Another important difference is the use of articles. In Spanish, we said la, okay, excuse me. We have la casa, el libro, la casa is female, the book is male, el libro, los libros, las casas. Okay, so year, number and year, singular, singular, female, male, singular, los male, plural, female, plural. But what happened in English? We don't have germ. We say the house. We said the book. We said the books, and we add the S. And this S tells us that it's plural, not the article. In Spanish, el artículo nos dice los, las, and we know that is plural. But in English, we use the, and that's all. So the noun is going to tell us if it's plural or not. El sustantivo nos va a indicar si es plural o no. Okay? So we have here the houses. Okay? What other different? Okay, so in English we have more prepositions than in Spanish. Another, okay, it is in English and also in Spanish. Remember that irregular noun, man, men, woman, women, okay? This is something that we have in Spanish and in English. Another difference is the conjugation of the verb, because in Spanish we said yo trabajo, él trabaja, ella trabaja, nosotros trabajamos, and we are many forms to conjugate the verb. So in English we have only two: I work, she and he works, we work, they work, you work, and that's all. So that is something that is different. Okay, this was just in order to review some differences we have. So it is important to know that there are similarities, but when we are going to conjugate the verb in English, is easy. In Spanish, it's more difficult, because in English we said, I work, she works, and that's all. But in Spanish we say, yo trabajo, él trabaja, ella trabaja. Tú trabajas, ustedes trabajan, nosotros trabajamos. So it's a lot of words. So in English, only you are going to use two. Okay, so let's continue with the other group. I want to listen to the others. So tell me the next. Who's the next? Roselyn. Roselyn, Roselyn. Wow. Interesting topic. That's an interesting topic.
¿Se ve la pantalla?
Yes, yes. Okay. I can see the screen.
Voy a presentar yo, teacher. Good morning, teacher. I have to the pleasure to present you or talk about phonetics difference between English and Spanish. The phonetics difference of the D is what the tip of the tongue on the palate on the D is the place between the sound is different.
Problem with having English or second language, Spanish. To attain native life, compete second language learning, most stability happens between family speed, sound, and next phoneme category. Example, Spanish learning as English must learn the and the. We are allowed the phonemes in Spanish can distinct meaning in the English. Example, they, ellos, they, día, weather, respirar, break, pan, there, allí, where. Atrevimiento. Dog, mediamente. Dog, casa, medida. Bait, bañarse. Bait, orden. Spanish and English listing democratic grade sensitive data.
The letter D occupies the fourth place in Spanish alphabet. It is a consonant and is the third letter of the international Latin alphabet. Phonetically, it is a closed letter which to be pronounced, the teeth are used and the tongue support by the incisor. In this way, it will be easier to pronounce. That there are other phonic variations of the B, V, and G. Sounds that exist in Spanish that we do not produce in English. It's commonly used to transcribe a voice, fricate, dental consonant,
Okay, students. There is something similar to the problem we face with ba and va. So what happened with this sound? This sound is the sound of and. Okay, what occurs? In Spanish, we have dedo, dime, diente. So we put our tongue tip in the alveolar ridge. Dedo. What is the alveolar ridge? Esto que tenemos aquí, que tenemos como una, como decirlo así, como corrugadito aquí, en la encía. That is alveolar ridge. And we say, dedo, diente, dime. And we put our tongue tip like this. Dime, diente, dedo, donde. But in English, we have two sounds. We have the and we have the interdental sound. What is interdental? Then those. So our tongue tip is touching our teeth. La lengua está en medio de los dientes. So in Spanish, it doesn't affect meaning. So it is the same. We can say diente, 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 and it is the same. But in English, we have a difference that affects meaning. So it is not the same when we say this, 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 then, the, and when we say dog, dog, dog. The sound is different. And how can we avoid this? It's by doing the same thing, by practicing minimal pairs. So it is the same I tried to explain with the other presentation. So we have these two different sounds. The sound of the, as in dog, dog, that we can touch the alveolar ridge or little bit the palate, but usually we touch the alveolar ridge, the, as in dog, dog, dog. But we have the other sound of th, as in this, this, dog, this, dog, this. So we should practice the pronunciation of these sounds in order to avoid mistakes. So we have they, done, breathe, though, worthy, die. And we have they, done, breathe, though, worthy, die. So in order to contrast and notice the difference, we practice they, sorry, they, done, than, breathe, breathe, though, worthy, worthy, die, die. So that pronunciation is a little bit different and it affects that meaning of the word. It's not the same to say, my day is perfect. My day is perfect. So they are perfect. My day is perfect and they are perfect. So it's different. So I don't know if we have, I think I have another group. Is there another group? ¿Hay otro grupo? Chicos, no more groups. No?
No, teacher.
Okay, that's fine. Okay, students. So remember, you should upload this final project. Okay. And I'm going to need a favor. So when we finish, I need all of you send a message with your name and with your ID, because I'm going to check all the activities, the test, and if I need something or I don't understand something, I'm going to call you and I need to check your information in my list, because I'm going to send the evaluation to all of you and I need all your information correctly, because I'm going to check the activities. If I have a question, I'm going to call you. So when we finish, please send a message. Fulanito de tal, ID, phone number, okay? Because during the day and tomorrow, I'm going to check all the activities and I have to send your final evaluation to all of you, okay? En español, when we finish the class, cuando terminamos la clase, envíe un mensaje con su nombre, su cédula, su teléfono. ¿Por qué? Porque entre hoy y mañana voy a evaluar. Recuerde mandar su trabajo. Y entonces, si tengo alguna duda, algo que corregir o algo que no entiendo, algo que no haya recibido, yo lo voy a llamar. So in the same way, I'm going to give you your final evaluation. Cuando tengo su evaluación final, se la envío también. Okay, so I'm going to call the roll again, and we're going to conclude that class. Okay, if you have something to say, si tiene algo que decir, algún comentario, alguna reflexión, algo que podamos mejorar en otra ocasión, qué le gustó, qué no le gustó, puede decirlo en este momento.
Thank you, teacher, for this class and the other class in the past, in the last weekend. It's amazing, because now I really study the English and help me so much, because maybe the people listen, I can talk very fast, but my English is terrible. It's so bad and maybe function sometimes, but not the thing I want, because I know the people listen to me and think, oh my goodness, this guy talk very bad. And I don't want this thing more, and I want practice more. Thank you. Thank you so much for this opportunity.
You have improved a lot. You have improved a lot. Edith?
Thank you, teacher. En Spanish. Bueno, creo que ha sido de gran valía, ¿verdad? Lograr todas estas cuatro semanas o cuatro fines de semana consecutivos. Yo volví nuevamente al colegio con esta clase, y de repente, pues, recordar las clases de español, y haciendo una analogía entre los dos idiomas, pues nos dimos cuenta de las diferencias, realizando los trabajos, pues hemos logrado al menos ver que hay grandes diferencias que de repente, pues, a simple vista no las podíamos observar, porque lo veíamos de manera separado. Pero ahora, de manera así en conjunto, pues nos dimos cuenta que sí hay grandes diferencias entre el español y el inglés. Y que de repente, pues cuando nosotros hablamos, generalmente hacemos una traducción de manera textual, palabra por palabra, como que si estuviéramos en el español. Y nos hemos dado cuenta, pues, que no. O sea, cuando hacemos una oración que ya está pre-elaborada, lo hacemos bien, pero cuando nosotros hablamos, no como los compañeros que ya tienen mucha más experiencia en esto,
Nosotros, yo por lo general hablo de manera, o sea, lo hablo de manera personal y lo digo, yo hago la traducción una por una y hablo así mismo como, o sea, lo traduzco así mismo como lo veo lo en español, pero que sí tiene pues su cambio. Con esto hemos aprendido, pues bueno, al menos yo le hablo de manera particular, he aprendido y he visto pues los cambios significativos y bueno, hay que tratar de mejorar en lo sucesivo. Gracias, profe, por todo este tiempo, porque ha sido para usted, para dar clase a los, bueno, los que ya están bien adelantados, perfecto, pero los que estamos, pero bueno, Dios primero, vamos a ir logrando algo y hemos logrado de manera significativa muchas cosas, muchas palabras en cuanto a lo que es la tarea. Todo lo que hemos hecho, he aprendido palabras nuevas que no las conocía en inglés y hay palabras que son muy similares al español que de repente pues podían formar parte de un bagaje, de un conocimiento general. Gracias, profe, y queridos compañeros, pues disculpen todas las atorrancias, porque pero bueno, ahí vamos logrando nuestros objetivos. Cuídense mucho.
Amigos, compañeros, viene a mi memoria un texto, el carpintero de Galilea, Jesús decía, los sanos no necesitan de médicos, sino aquellos que están enfermos. Entonces quiero decirles que no le tengan miedo a equivocarse, las escuelas son para los que no saben, Y para fortaleza de los que saben. Cada clase que podamos ver, dámosla como una puerta abierta a un conocimiento nuevo. Equivocarnos no significa que estemos mal. Equivocarnos significa que tenemos la oportunidad de mejorar, la oportunidad de corregir algo en nosotros. Cuando nos enfrentemos a algo que no conocemos, no tengamos miedo a preguntar cómo se hace, cómo se dice, y eso va a traer muchísimos frutos buenísimos en nuestra vida, va a nutrir nuestro intelecto, sí, nuestra capacidad, pero también nuestra personalidad, también nuestro carácter va a ser formado a través de oportunidades. Profesora, ha sido un privilegio poder estar en su clase, me siento honrado y poder repasar todo este montón de herramientas gramaticales que hace tiempo veía y no las había vuelto a ver. Me ha dado mucho gusto estar en su clase y conocerle, profesora. Muchísimas gracias. Un honor tenerla acá.
Ahora me corresponde a mí. Quería decirle que bueno, que aunque yo no estuve en la clase pasada por motivos de varias cositas, de verdad es que he disfrutado mucho la clase. Me hubiera gustado que hubiéramos estado en un salón practicando todo, porque siento que ahí hubiéramos aprovechado mucho más lo que, y me gustó sinceramente mucho porque hemos aprendido todo lo que es la lengua, la lingüística y todo eso, todo lo hemos aprendido. Parece como extraño saber que hay veces que pensamos que como lo que nos correspondió, la B y la V suenan en español casi igual. No pudimos aprender que tienen en inglés tiene su diferencia y las artículas, cómo se pronuncian y cómo es la articulación de la boca cuando se habla en inglés. Me dio mucho gusto que pudiéramos aprender algo más con usted de todo esto que nos ha dado, y ha sido muy valioso para mí el poder aprender o escucharla a usted pronunciar, porque se entiende, es tan clara la pronunciación que usted hace que me ha gustado escucharla cómo da la clase. Me hubiera gustado haber estado en la otra clase pasada para haber participado un poquito más. Pero la señal está muy, muy mala. Incluso ahorita se fue.